The island paradise of Hawaii and its native people have been involved in MMA since the early days of the sport. Hawaii's beautiful landscape and rich culture harbor some of the most talented fighters in the world today, and the sport might not have been the same if it wasn't for this small group of islands in the middle of the ocean. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Fight Dialogue. My name is Tim. So I wanted to give my take on the three best fighters to ever come out of Hawaii. Keep in mind, this is just an opinion-based list, and I base those opinions off of how many wins these fighters have in major MMA organizations and the quality of the opponents that they have faced. I must say, though, I had some real difficulty narrowing it all down. Like I said, Hawaiians have been around in MMA for a long time, and martial arts has really cemented itself in the culture there. So many great Hawaiian warriors from the past, present, and future up-and-comers. I really had my work cut out for me finding who was the best. But in any case, let's get into it. And as always, I like to talk a little bit about the place itself. Hawaii is a group of islands in the Pacific Ocean and is the 50th state in the U.S. It has a population of 1.4 million and its capital is Honolulu. Before it was the state, it was a U.S. territory. And before that, it was its own sovereign nation. Centuries of warring kingdoms established a noticeable warrior mentality that is mingled with the calmness one might expect from a people that live on a tropical island paradise. I really can't overstate what an endearing culture it is. So the number three guy on this list is a heavyweight named Travis Brown. He was born in Honolulu and his record in MMA is 18-7-1. He's known for being a surprisingly athletic and nimble striker, despite being one of the largest guys in the heavyweight division. Some of you watching may be scratching your head at this point, but to be frank, I think this is because MMA fans have a bit of a short memory. He did go on a bad losing streak after switching camps toward the end of his career, but in his prime, he was an absolute destroyer. His knockout of Stefan Struve was one of the craziest things I've ever seen, because he caught Struve while he was leaning back, and the punch just completely crumpled him. His arcing elbows against the cage versus Gonzaga was probably the first times we saw that technique in the UFC, and then he did the same thing to Josh Barnett. He's had notable wins against James McSweeney, Alistair Overeem, Josh Barnett, Brendan Schaub, and Matt Mitrione. And I'll never forget that crazy one-round war against Andre Arlovsky. So like I said, the latter half of his career wasn't as glorious as the early half, but at least I'll remember him as one of the best Hawaiian MMA fighters. And if not, certainly the best Hawaiian heavyweight MMA fighter. Next person on this list is the one and only BJ Penn. He was born in Kailua, and his record in MMA is 16-14-2. His style is a combination of excellent jiu-jitsu skills that he applies with inhuman flexibility and very excellent punches. Some of the newer MMA fans may not know who Baby J is, and if they do, they are probably baffled by this addition to the list due to his later career being so abysmal. And yet, if you're an old school MMA fan, you may be aghast at how he's not the number one guy on this list. But like I said, there's so many great Hawaiian fighters to pick from, it made this choice very hard for me. Penn is more than deserving of the top spot due to his wins over the likes of Cal Uno, Kenny Florian, Jens Pulver, Matt Serra, Henzo Gracie, Takanori Gomi, Dean Thomas, Joe Daddy Stevenson, Sean Shirk, and Matt Hughes twice. Many of these fights were title fights, and he would defend the lightweight belt for quite some time, and was only the second man in history to earn a belt in two different weight classes. But I also can't ignore the fact that he has the record for the longest losing streak in UFC history. To be fair, a lot of his losses were against guys who were absolutely enormous compared to him, and honestly, Penn should have been fighting at featherweight for his entire career, but couldn't because it wasn't really a thing back then. He instead had to fight comparative giants like GSP, Nick Diaz, Rory McDonald, and Lyoto Machida. Okay, well, he didn't have to fight those guys, but it still took balls, so you gotta give him that. And he fought big guys like that during the majority of his prime years. Despite the rough ending to his career, it was still a razor-close contest between him and the guy I consider to be number one, Max Holloway.
If you think it the best, come fight bless.
Max was born in Honolulu, Hawaii. His record in MMA is 21-5, and his style is highly technical volume striking with absolutely incredible takedown defense. Aside from being one of the best class acts in the sport in terms of personality, he is arguably the greatest featherweight champion of all time. And in an era of featherweights, that has never been better. He boasts one of the longest winning streaks in UFC history at 13 straight victories. Some of those victories were against the likes of Andre Feely, Cub Swanson, Charles Oliveira, Jeremy Stevens, Ricardo Lamas, Anthony Pettis, and Brian Ortega. And let's not forget his back-to-back wins against another member of featherweight royalty, Jose Aldo. He even had a close fight with Conor McGregor back in the day, and an amazing fight of the year against Dustin Poirier at lightweight. Not to mention he was beating grizzled veterans in the UFC like Leonard Garcia before he was even old enough to drink. He's still a young guy, and I think that he still has a lot of amazing things to do in the sport yet, so that's why I had to pick him over BJ Penn, because the potential to do more still exists for Max, and I can't wait to watch his next fight.
It is what it is.
Honorable mentions go to Brad Tavares, who has been a longtime contender in the UFC middleweight division, fighting some of the best guys in the world for a while, and ilima-lei McFarland, who is killing it as the current Bellator flyweight champ and is undefeated in her MMA career. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I plan on doing more videos like this in the future. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions, or if you disagree with me or agree with me, please let me know in the comments. And thanks so much for watching. Take care.